Serato DJ Lite is a free DJ software that you can use with a wide range of controllers like the Pioneer DJ DDJ SB2. Only certain controllers support Serato DJ Lite, so be sure to check if your controller is Serato supported. Serato DJ Pro is an upgrade that has more features and functions that you will want to explore as you progress with your DJing. You can purchase a license for Serato DJ Pro, which will allow you to use it with your controller and many other supported pieces of Pro hardware. To connect a controller to use with Serato DJ Lite, you'll need to plug the DDJ SB2 into your computer via the USB port. You may need to install drivers for your device. These can be found on either the manufacturer's website or on Serato.com. Once installed, you will be able to connect your hardware with your computer to use with Serato DJ Lite and not have to install them again. To import music into Serato DJ Lite, you can use the Files panel and drag a folder to the crate area like this. If you prefer, you can also use your iTunes library. Select the option to show iTunes library in the setup menu of Serato DJ Lite under the Library and Display tab. In iTunes, make sure you have the option to share the iTunes XML enabled in iTunes Preferences under the Advanced tab if it doesn't show up immediately. Once you have your tracks in Serato DJ Lite, it's a good idea to analyze your files. You can either drag the ones you want to analyze to the Analyze Files button, or click the Analyze Files button to analyze your entire library. This will tag the BPM on tracks, which will allow you to sort your library by BPM from either slowest to fastest or vice versa. Now you can start choosing your tracks based on the tempos, which will allow you to find songs that are in a similar range. To stay organized, utilize the Crates function to arrange your sets. Just click the Crate button here. Now you can drag your songs in as you like. Order them by BPM or however you'd like to have them organized by selecting one of the options from the library tabs. Load your tracks by dragging them to the deck with your mouse, or on the controller by clicking the load button on the side you want to load to. Start your track by pressing the play button and bring up the line fader and crossfader to the side. Load your second track relative to the first track's BPM and either use sync to match the tempos by clicking sync on the track you are bringing in or by using the tempo slider. Use the cue point buttons on the controller to cue the tracks in. I always set a cue point at the beginning of my tracks so I can jump back to the start. You can also use the temp cue button too. This will bring the track back to the start and stop it. It's important to note that the temp cue button doesn't save to the file and will be gone the next time you load the track. Once you have your tempos matched, bring up the line fader and crossfader across to mix in your new track. Use the effects buttons to add some spice to your mix, with reverbs, phasers, and delays. Click on the effects option at the top of the screen to open the effects panel. Now turn the effects on as you choose and bring the wet dry knob up to affect the track. Add in your own samples too to spice up your performance or let people know your DJ name. Open up the sample player by clicking on the airhorn symbol at the top of the screen. This opens the sample player panel below the decks. Drag sounds and sound effects in from your library or from the files panel. On the controller, you can enter the sampler mode by clicking on the sampler button above the cues. This will make the top four pads trigger your four sample slots. These are all fun techniques and options you can use in Serato DJ Lite with the DDJ SB2. Get in the mix and try these out for yourself at home or at your next gig.